everyone, how are you all? Welcome to my podcast Sangrila with Ila Anand Acharya. So this is season 3 episode number 4 and the title is Virtual Reality. Yes, if you have known about the term visualization, you will definitely going to understand what virtual reality means. So over here, this is a process suggested by Abraham teachings, and where she talks about creating a scene or creating a virtual reality which we want to make it as a dream come true into our life. So over here there are certain rules which we have to follow. That is, first and foremost, we have to be in a kind of a happy, relaxed mood to create a virtual reality. And another thing is that this virtual reality process which we have to use to create a happy scene where we want everything to be at its best place, and not to fix something and not to repair something or about some relationship or about some situation. This is not about problem solving. It is about creating a virtual reality which we want it into our life. So for example, I want that my life should be smooth and my day-to-day work should be easy and it should go with the flow. Then in a very happy and relaxed mood, I will just sit back for 15-20 minutes and I will visualize that, yes, every day I am waking up at 5 o'clock in the morning. I'm doing my meditation, I'm doing my release of podcasting. Then after some other regular works, I'm sitting, I'm reading my book, I'm having my nice lunch, and like this, it with the flow, whatever we want in our reality, we will just create it, like a movie director who directs his own movie. And there is so many things which are related with, like, in which location I want that movie to be directed, what, who all will be the characters in it, and what will be the weather condition, what will be the time, night, afternoon. So similarly, when I'm just doing my visualization process and this virtual reality process, I will imagine all the things which I really want. Okay, so this process is going to help you to be in a no resistance process where we are easily allowing it the things to come. Also, it will help us to imagine more, it will help us to feel good, and it will help us to have this no resistance vibration feeling in our vortex, and we will definitely going to bring all these good things and good dreams come true into our life. So we can say this process is very much important for us to make our life wonderful and beautiful as we want, because this process is going to smoothen everything. Regularly or daily we keep on visualization, we do visualization, we do various things, but in that thing, what you visualize is mostly about bad things might come into you. Like if we are sitting just like that and we'll imagine about what is going to happen next in our life, we are lacking money, we are lacking in health. So instead of using that time or wasting, I can say wasting that time in creating a negative reality, negative things or emotions and circumstances into our life, we can use that time by creating a very beautiful virtual reality and good scenes into our life. So I think this you can do anytime, anywhere, but make sure that you are in a happy, good mood and you feel you want to imagine something which you really want in your life. So this virtual reality process is all about the moment, it's all about the time. And since the universe responds to a vibration and not to what you are living right now, amazing things can begin to flow into your experience even when they have never done so before. So you cannot think that I am right now, I am having no money or I am having lack of money. How can I imagine about lots of money? But it is your vibration to which the law of attraction responds. So yes, you can imagine. But just have a good feeling at that time, and then imagine about a bank account in which you have, you know, such and such amount of money, and you are going to spend it at your leisure to whatever you want. So this virtual reality process is really very helpful to bring into your life all the good manifestations. Okay, so I hope you have understood it, and if you have any doubt, any questions, please let me know. I'm really very thankful to all those who are listening to my podcast episode. Thank you so much.